how Christ releases and sets free, how he turns ashes into garland, how he repairs and builds up what was ruined. We too will point others to Jesus, the light of the world. Amen. So let's stand now. It's verse number 3 this morning of hymn number 69.
Click on each of those hands.
This candle's hope.
We name this candle peace. And we name this candle joy.
That's okay.
No.
Now you gotta blow out the one in the purple. There you go.
Yeah. We too are on a journey.
Set our face steadily towards the light. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, as we search for signs of joy this week, help us to become the signs of joy that others are searching for. As these candles are but a glimpse of the light of heavens, help us to be the glimpse of heaven's joy. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Nice job. It's harder than it looks. So, welcome. Oh my gosh. Okay, so let me just say what I see this morning. Welcome to all you great little kids. Hey, we're so glad you're here. And big kids, sorry. Welcome to moms and sisters and dads and uncles and moms and dads and little brothers and boys. It's great. Well, how about people that have returned from the vacation of a lifetime and all the way from Mexico? Welcome to Jennifer and the boys. We're so glad you're here. And members that we haven't seen for a while. So we're just really glad that everyone's here to celebrate this. What is today? Third Sunday of Advent. And our Christmas light show. So with that all being said, I say to you, our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you.
And also with you.
Amen. So let's stand and sing hymn number 93. Go tell it on the brothers and sisters, in Jesus Christ, the Lord has done great things for us. Even if we have gone out in tears, God brings us home shouting for joy. Thanks be to God. We are all forgiven. Amen.
Christian, we are not seeing in silence those lights. We are seeing the Holy Child will come.
That has anything this morning, Terry?
My daughter-in-law's father
last week. Mm-hmm. It was doing better, and it's in the hospital with all the mommy now, and that doing great.
What's his name? Dan.
Don might be going to rehab early this coming week. Everybody's fingers crossed. He's been up and down again, but yeah, doing good.
You carry for Dan, for sure. Yeah. Anyone else? All right, let's pray. God of Advent, who promises to come again in restoration and wholeness, we acknowledge that our needs are not so different from those people of long ago. We too wander in darkness. We yearn for your light to come into our lives. Trusting in Christ, we bring our prayers for the world. We pray for the world that is shaped by so much sin. We pray that those oppressed will be set free, that those who are bound by injustice will find a new life. We ask that you help us form this world more closely into the image of your kingdom. Help us to be faithful in all things, big and small, and be your people in the world. We pray for our nation. May unity and goodwill have the last word. May we see ourselves not by what divides us, but by our identity as your beloved creation. Particularly when it comes to political parties and affiliation, temper our desire to win or be right with a concern for the greater good. We pray for those who are sick, for Lynn, for Michelle, and for Don. Grant them the sure and certain knowledge of your love and care, and may we each, as your people, be a community that cares and heals for those who grieve or who are near death, for Marilyn's family, and for the family, for all families that are near death. For Ryan, we ask for a special blessing. In all things, Lord, may we point towards you and your light in the world. We ask it all in the name of Jesus and offer together the prayer that he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Okay, take two. Take two on that. Now, does this work?
Yes.
Before we get started, you are welcome to take photos. These are kind of cute little things. No, except with David Jansen. You are welcome to take photos. This is a very cute little program, and we're just really glad that you're all here. I personally want to say thank you to Lynn and Corey and Renee and Gail and Barbara, too, for being able to pull this all together. This is kind of a cute little thing. So, hello. Welcome to our Christmas light show, where the star is Jesus, but the performers are all of you. Surprise. Throughout the program, we'll need lots of people to join us on stage to play 17 different parts. So don't be shy, and they're awful cute, so don't turn them down. And let's have some fun. So we'll need to start our Christmas light show with, what else? Lights. So of course we need two Christmas light pros. So you guys, you two Christmas light pros, come on up.
It's Christmas time again. I'm excited. The music, the food, the presents, and the lights.
Plug them in.
Sometimes we get so tangled up in the busyness of Christmas that we don't take the time to really celebrate the true meaning of Christmas.
Oh, hang on. We have a problem. We can't put lights on the Christmas trees until we get them untangled. So let's make this a little competition. Let's see who can get their Christmas lights untangled first. While we're doing that, we're all going to sing a song together called Light It Up.
Can you come one more time? They got it.
They told everyone they saw about the true light that had been born in Bethlehem. Let's give a round of applause.
Hey, now it's our turn to meet Jesus' parents. Join the stage. Who are the smartest guys in the room? Any valedictorians? Any engineers? Does anyone own a telescope? Where are you? Yeah, right? Okay. Yep, and Dad? And who's the third?
down here. Stand right over here. Okay. Can you stop? Let's do this.
Watch out for the candles.
Oh, Dennis, there you are. McKenna, watch the candles, please.
Go from the back.
Okay, next we need one person to be our bright star. Who's someone with a bright personality? Who is it?
Looking for a sign. And one day, a new star appeared. It was so bright. The wise men knew that this was the sign that we were looking for, so they followed the star. Okay, so stars, you need to walk around the stage and into the audience, and the wise men are going to follow you. Ready?
Don't walk around
the whole place. Go together.
Yep. There
come
you
on.
Go.
Come on, guys. Come on. Don't get tangled or
caught. And don't get set of flea. Put your legs.
Push the flames.
Yeah. There you go.
Day and night, they followed the star. They grew tired and weary, but they never took their eyes off the star. Eventually, the star stopped. Stop. Okay, come on all the way back up to the stage, star. The Christmas star had stopped in Bethlehem. There the wise men found the true light of Christmas, Jesus. They gave Jesus gifts of gold and incense and precious myrrh. How about a round of applause for our wise men and our bright stars?
Okay, now it's time to meet Jesus' parents. I jumped ahead a little bit. So, where are you out here? So, let's... where are Mary and Joseph out here? Yes, well, we need to go find them. There she goes. Okay, just one. Where's Joseph? Where's Mary? There you go. Come on, Jenny.
The Savior of the world was born in a stable. The Son of God became the son of two humble humans, Mary and Joseph. Jesus is the true light of Christmas. Jesus was the living word that John wrote about in the Bible.
So listen now to what John said. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life,
And that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decisions, or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. All right. No, I was going to get the three wise men. So we want to invite all of, nope, you're already up here. Everybody stay up here. For all those in the audience, we invite you now to take out your phones and flip on your flashlights while we sing the next song. Sing is the key word. It is called Shine Your Light.
So let me shout it.
the true light of Christmas. And we have the opportunity to shine the light of Jesus wherever we go. So before we go, let's sing the first couple of verses to Joy to the World. One click post. Hit it, Joyce.